Hey, this is Rob. I'm going to be going over the workflow that I use when working with 360 photos that are from the Insta360 ONE X camera. There's two software programs we'll be using. They're both free. The first one is the Insta360 Studio for ONE X and beta, and the other one is the Insta360 Player. Okay, let's get started. This is a workflow for a desktop, either Mac or Windows. Here's where you can find the Insta360 Studio for ONE X beta software. I'll put a link in the description below. And here's where you can find the Insta360 Player. I'll also put a link for this in the description below. So when we put the microSD card from the Insta360 ONE X into the desktop, we get these files. On top are the image files. When we look at the properties of one of the image files, the extension of these files are INSP. INSP stands for Insta Photo, the P for photo. On the bottom are the 360 video files. And when we look at the properties of one of these video files, the extension is INSV, Insta Video, V for video. We begin with the Insta360 Studio for ONE X beta. They name this beta, but I doubt if it will ever go out of beta. These companies never really update their free software. Going to File here in the upper left. Import. It says footages. Footages in this software means both videos and photos. Control. Settings. Stopping in window. The stitching panel is here on the right. The timeline panel is this here for video. The footages panel is here on the left. Under help, there are no help files for this software. And if you want to check for updates, you tap here. We'll go to the stitching panel here. Under application, we have two tabs. Click on stabilization. Stabilization is for videos. Stitching, keep it on normal. Click on calibration. No idea. I don't use it for 360 photos. Logo settings. Click here if you want to use a bottom logo. A bottom logo covers up a tripod if you put the Insta360 ONE X on a tripod to take 360 photos. You can make your own logo. They recommend a 500 by 500 pixels PNG format image as a logo. Or what I've seen other people do, they place their tripod on grass, they will take a photo of a patch of that grass and make a grass logo for that 360 photo to cover up the tripod. I will now drag in some photos in the footages panel. Up here in the upper right is a drop-down box, which gives you different choices on how to view your 360-degree photo. Up top is asteroid view. I think this is the same as the tiny planet. Next is crystal ball view. Fish eye view. Perspective view. This room was the commodity exchange in the early 1500s in Valencia, Spain. Now it is a tourist attraction. Next is the equirectangular or flat image. I'm going to go back to perspective view and look at the bottom logo again. Going to the bottom of the image. I was just holding the Insta360 ONE X in my hand above my head. I'm going to click on the Use Bottom logo. This is the logo that comes with the software. Use this slider to make it bigger. And as I said before, if you click change here, you can choose one of your own logos that you created. Processing and exporting images. Right now my image is in an INSP format. I want to export it into a JPEG format so that other applications can use this 360-degree photo. You can select one image or all the images in the Footages panel. Then in the upper right, click on this yellow icon here. This window pops up. You can change the resolution, the file name, and choose the location where you want the exported JPEG image to be stored. Changing the resolution, typing in the left box, the numbers automatically change in the right box to keep the same aspect ratio of the image. Press OK to start the exporting. This window pops up. When it's done exporting, you will hear that sound, and you can also see here 100%. But this window does not go away automatically. You have to close it. Batch processing. When we process more than one photo, we get a different pop-up window. We can choose a target resolution, turn on and choose the bottom logo, and choose the location where we want the exported images to be stored. I will fast forward this part. Now we'll switch to the Insta360 player. This is the Insta360 player. Even though it says that this player supports INSP formats, this player was programmed before the Insta360 1X, and when I try to open an INSP file from the 1X, it does not handle it correctly. The player inverts the image, and I cannot control the image correctly. So I open only the processed JPEG's 1X photos into this player. Let's open a JPEG 1X photo. If you move the cursor to the bottom center, these options appear. They give us the same view options as before, but a couple of them are named differently. But they are the same view options. The flat image, crystal ball, perspective, little planet, but the main reason I'm showing you this Insta360 player software is for this icon here, screenshot icon. I'm going to move this image around. And I want to take a screenshot of this part of the image here. Click the screenshot icon. Select where you want the image to be saved. The screenshot takes a high resolution of this part of the 360 photo, and I will show you the resolution of that image in a minute. If you go to the settings menu here and click here, you can set a location where you want all your screenshots to be stored. Then click Confirm. So next time when you click Screenshot, it does not ask you where you want the screenshot to go. Then when it is finished taking the screenshot, it gives you a pop-up message, Snapshot Succeeded. In this Settings icon, click on it. You can choose how you want to rotate the viewing of your images in this player, by dragging the screen or dragging the mouse. Right now it's set to drag the screen. Click on Drag the Mouse. Then you just move your mouse to rotate the image. Dragging the mouse gives you a smoother movement. Taking a look at the screenshot image size in Photoshop. Image, image size. That screenshot photo is a 3769 by 1936 pixels at 96 pixels per inch. So that gives you a decent resolution if you want to crop the image for different social media platforms. Okay, that is it. That is one way for you to work with your Insta360 1X photos, especially if you're a beginner in 360 images. Okay, if you've not bought the 360 1X video camera yet, I'll put a link below, and you can either buy it from Amazon or directly from the company. If you buy it from Amazon, you'll get it quicker. If you buy it directly from the company, they'll give you a free selfie stick, but it's going to take you longer for the delivery because they're going to ship it from China. Also, check out a couple of my other videos here on the 360 1X.